Hi, this is Shweta from ClearTax, and today I will speak about submission of Form 15CA and 15CB. In case you make payments outside India, you need to submit a Form 15CA. The payment may be taxable or may not be taxable, and you need to obtain a Form 15CB from a chartered accountant in case the payment is taxable in India and it is above Rs. 5 lakhs. Form 15CA and 15CB are necessary only if you are making payments to non-residents outside India or to foreign companies outside India. However, you do not need to submit a Form 15CA or obtain a 15CB in case of payments which are not requiring any kind of RBI approval and in case where the payments are made as individual remittances. Form 15CA should be submitted by the taxpayer who wants to make the remittance. Form 15CA consists of four parts. The Part A consists of remittances which are below 5 lakh and chargeable to tax. Part B consists of remittances which are below Rs. 5 lakh and which are chargeable to tax. However, those payments are the ones for which a taxpayer has obtained a nil withholding order or a lower withholding order from the assessing officer. Part C consists of payments which are chargeable to tax and which are above Rs. 5 lakh. These payments are the ones for which the taxpayer has to obtain a Form 15CB from a chartered accountant. And Part D consists of remittances which are not chargeable to tax. These are other than those remittances which are specifically exempt under Rule 37BB, a certain payments which are not at all covered in the list of payments requiring a Form 15CA. But before a taxpayer submits a Form 15CA, in case of payments covered under Part C, those which are chargeable to tax and which are above Rs. 5 lakh, the taxpayer should first obtain a Form 15CB from a CA. So let us understand what Form 15CB consists of. Form 15CB is a certificate from a chartered accountant certifying the details of the payment. The details such as the name, address, the country to which the remittance is made, the type of payment, the tax under the India tax law and the tax under the tax treaty with such country, the amount of payment in Indian currency as well as in the foreign currency and the details of the bank which is remitting the payment. In case the payment is claimed as tax exempt, the CA should also mention that section under which the payment is claimed as exempt. The CA should also mention the nature of payment under the tax treaty and also obtain a tax residence certificate from the recipient of the payment. After providing the details of the tax due under the Indian tax law and the tax due under the tax treaty and choosing the beneficial provisions for making the remittance, you should indicate the amount of TDS that you are deducting and the rate of TDS that you are choosing, whether as per the tax treaty or as per the Indian tax law. You need to mention the date of deducting the TDS and the final remittance after reducing the TDS. The CA can file a Form 15CB online. For this purpose, the CA must be registered as a chartered accountant on the e-filing portal. And also the taxpayer must add the CA for the purpose of submission of Form 15CB. The CA can fill in the details of the Form 15CB and submit the Form 15CB online under the digital signature. It is only after the filing of Form 15CB by the CA that the taxpayer can submit a Form 15CA after viewing the details from the Form 15CB. The taxpayer can submit a Form 15CA online through the digital signature from their e-filing login. To know the details of remittances which are exempt from Form 15CA and Form 15CB, refer to our page on Form 15CA and Form 15CB. Do like and share our videos and do not forget to hit the bell icon for notifications. Thank you.